tastes like some chicken nuggets. Eat that thing with some fucking ranch with some lemon pepper stepper. Yeah. Hello,
this is my little rich kitty.
Hey family, welcome to my channel.
I am in the bathroom. Mind your business. I like the lighting in here, so we're gonna rock with it. Excuse me if you hear stuff in the background. They out there doing what they do. Ain't got nothing to do with me, but they are kind of loud, so bear with me. This is gonna be a quick little get to know me. I'm looking at myself. I need to be looking right here. I would like to kind of like, y'all want one more time to interrupt me.
So I'm holding up my camera because I like this lighting. Thank you, Samra. Do I net you?
Thank you for revitalizing my spirit and my soul. Thank you for supplying vitamin D. Period. As the seasons change, I need the sun more and more. I need you, Ra. Girl, you are interrupting my video. Isis.
So to start, I do a few things.
I'ma just hold this motherfucker because at this point, I can't even hear myself think. God. To start, what I plan on doing and incorporating on my page, on my channel, everything spiritual. I'm a spiritual being. I am on my spiritual journey. I've been on it for a while. I feel like I'm credible in a sense to give information, to share, you know, my wisdom and my knowledge just from what I've experienced throughout my journey. Everything I've gained, everything I know I can be of help. I can be of light to someone else. Girl. So yeah, everything spiritual. I love to cook. I love to eat. So there would be some of that. Cooking with Lay. Plan to do tarot as well. It may be Tarot Tuesdays. Or just sometime at the end of the week with my baby girl. She assists in my readings sometimes. I'm more on the intuitive reading, psychic medium type. I'm very uncomfortable with the labels right now as I'm finding like my way, my comfortability in the field that I'm in, like all that I practice and all that I'm able to do. But she assists very much so in my readings, especially ancestral readings, connecting to the energy of the dead. And yeah, it sounds a little crazy, but that's just real. And I'm gonna show y'all more of that. I'm gonna let y'all in because I know I suck at posting, being consistent in posting like on my social media pages, but this is gonna help me stay consistent and just all that I wanna do, all that I wanna share. So yeah. What else? I'm a little whining goddess. I'll insert a clip right now. Like holding myself up, if y'all could see the way I'm here trying to keep my balance.
This is dedication though. This is what dedication looks like. Just do it.
I've been trying to find the perfect setup for my channel and the perfect way to make it. Like there's no perfect way of doing it. Just gotta do it. So this is me just doing it. If you respect that, you a true writer. You know what I'm saying? Also plan on doing,
actually I'm not even gonna tell y'all. I'm gonna just pop out with it when it's time, because it ain't time to really speak on it. But just know I got things in the works, and
I just want to share that with people. I want to share my light and everything that I do, because I do so much. I tend to get overlooked, but that's because I overlook myself. I don't really put myself out there when I should. I have so many ideas and then I don't execute them out of fear of the unknown, fear of, you know, what people may think and say. I'm over that, so
you don't really see me on my shit.
For this channel and for myself, like I'm doing this for myself. This channel is an oath to myself to stay on top of, you know, everything I want to do in this lifetime. I literally started my lock journey not too long ago,
and it's already flourishing
and growing beautifully and budding. It goes to show my growth and how quick I transition, how much I grow. It's so real, and I want y'all to see that. I want y'all to experience that with me as my life is changing forevermore by the second. I'm gaining so much more insight and clarity. I'm connected to all that's around me.
One of my ancestors just popped up, and I'll talk to y'all about that. If y'all want to know more of like symbolism.
Hold on, I gotta sneeze. Hotep. God damn. Probably shouldn't sneeze and then cuss in the same. But yeah, so a part of this lock journey that I'm on, I'm kind of just rambling at this point. But a part of this lock journey is, you know, just to track and document my growth and to see it. And I don't think there's a better way of doing that in this moment for me personally, other than starting a YouTube channel, documenting my growth over time. This is only the beginning. And baby, we going places. And this is just me talking to myself, like, I'm done sleeping on myself. I'm done being unheard. I want people to want to hear me, you know? Like, anyone who comes to my page, to my channel, I want y'all to gain something from my videos every single time, even when I'm being my goofies. I'm gonna learn something. I'm a goofy motherfucker.
Tarot, cooking.
Poetry, podcasts, figuring out how I'm gonna go about my podcast. But it's gonna be some juicy topics. Actually, if y'all don't mind leaving me some comments below, you can just leave me, like, topics for podcasts, things that y'all would want me to speak on for, like, 15-20 minutes, you know, and with certain guests and whatnot. We're gonna get that cracking because it's time to elevate. The seasons are getting cold. Seasonal depression is oh so real. This is when you really have to start to expand your knowledge spiritually and ground yourself spiritually so that you are okay during these changes, because we depend on the sun a lot more than we think. Just making sure mental health, like, you're on top of your mental health. Mental health is spirituality. That's the whole my mental health is my biggest thing now. And I take pride in, you know, the knowledge that I have spiritually, because it applies to my mental health, my mental strength, and what I'm able to share with people. It could really be like a whole therapy channel, therapy page. Like, I'm with all that shit. I want to grow, and I want others to see the growth in me within themselves. I want y'all to, I'm out of breath. That's because I'm talking my shit. Okay, so now for my Q&A questions. My most asked question is, how did I get into spirituality?
One thing I will say is about most spiritual beings or light workers or whoever was on their journey, a lot of us are star seeds, or, you know, already basically tapped in, like, from a very young age. Typically the kids who are, like, you know, the outsiders, the ones who are the underdogs, the ones who are always counted out. Like, that's me still to this day, and it's cool.
I don't know how to explain it, but, like, pretty much all of my life
I've been a spiritual being, you know. Just in retrospect, when I look back at my childhood, or, you know, just growing up, my life so far, I see the way I navigate and I've operated, and I've just always been spiritual. I've always had an awakening, even though I haven't been aware of it. That makes sense, and that's pretty much the case for a lot of people. Consciously being on this journey,
started back in, like, 2018, 2019. It really started 2019, like August 2019.
I had a really bad breakup. And it's not like it was really bad,
but it was just one of those situations where I was doing so much for this man, not getting nothing back in return.
No love, like, just nothing. And I felt so depleted.
I felt like I lost myself, and I was still getting to know myself. Like, I didn't know myself, so I was just far gone, and I needed something. So I watched the documentary. It's called The Power of Now, I believe. And I watched, like, it was a whole 1 hour, 2 hour documentary. I took notes on it, and I really connected to, like, the laws. Just the laws of the universe, the universal laws of life, of love, everything. I just started taking notes.
I love for it. I'm like, all right, I feel good after studying this. Like, how can I do more for myself? That's pretty much where my journey started. I just had curiosity for it because it started to make sense to me.
Trying to navigate through my light and through acceptance, for real, for real. I had a second moment, though. It was a second heartbreak that really helped me.
And this one is what really jump-started, like, me being consistent and,
you know, my spiritual journey and making sure that I'm taking time,
like, damn near daily to, you know, heal and to reflect. Like, I took it very serious.
I just had to spiritually elevate for myself, to show myself that I'ma stand, you know, in my power. I'ma always come through for myself regardless, because I've never had anyone
emotionally there for me.
It's just always been me having to sort through my emotions. And as a woman, we already deal with that. So, you know, my inner child emotions and how I used to handle things, that's really been, like, the test and everything that I... So, yeah, y'all want, like, a personal video for just my spiritual journey.
Y'all just want to spin off on that topic, like, let me know. Another question I got was, what are my favorite vegan foods? I hope to share that on my channel. I'm not going to say too much, but I would definitely start making little recipe videos for my channel specifically. And these are going to be foods that I enjoy cooking, enjoy eating, and they're vegan. So, you know, I'm still learning, preparing my own food, using ingredients that are of source, that are of God, to nurture this body of mine, the spirit of mine. The goal is to have a God body, baby. Off tops, though, I used to make these fried, it's not the best, but fried mushrooms. Like, I still be making the fuck out of some fried mushrooms. It's like some chicken nuggets. Eat that thing with some motherfucking ranch, with some lemon pepper stepper. Yeah. The one, not the two.
Oh, and before I forget, I would love to do a guided meditation as well.
Maybe like a meditation Monday to start the week's meditation on Monday. Guided meditation y'all can come to on my page.
It'll be guided, so I'll be speaking over it.
Guide you through the meditation if you have like any issues meditating on your own, or if you're always in your head and like you just don't know how to quiet your mind and all of that. I would like to assist in that. So yeah, meditation on Mondays. Bear with me as I get my days together. Whoop, whoop, that's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop.
Someone asked me if I have a skincare routine, if I do anything for my skin. And my skincare routine, I don't have anything specific. I used to love getting into like DIYs and just figuring out what works best with my skin. Like I used to make aloe vera turmeric scrubs for my face. Where I'm at now, I will say clean eating, drinking water, fresh pressed juices, fresh fruits, vegetables. That's really helped my skin clear up. I'm about to start my period as well, so ladies, you already know how that goes. But yeah, that concludes my video. Thank y'all for tuning in and watching all the way through. If you did, you get a motherfucking cookie. Peace, love, and light to all of you. May you all have a great, blessed, sacred day. Never lose sight of yourself.